Again, welcome. We do have one singer who has signed up. So Mia, if you are here, will you please raise your hand or type in the chat that you are here? And then also be aware, it looks like we had a couple of cancellations, so we probably would have time for a volunteer or two. So if you are interested in volunteering to sing today, we would love to have you sing. So first of all, Mia, are you here? I believe that's who we have signed up, is Mia Herrera. Are you here in the room? Well, hopefully she joins us soon. But in the meantime, oh, maybe she's having some Zoom challenges. Okay. In the meantime, I'm going to go ahead and turn the time over to Jennifer and Marc, and they can introduce themselves and tell us a little bit about Ithaca. And then also, as I mentioned, if you are interested in singing, I'd love to have you let me know. You're welcome to say it in the chat. You can send it to me privately or raise your hand, whatever. And we'd love to have a couple more singers, even if you're just working on something and it's not perfected. I'm sure Marc and Jennifer would love to work with you on it. So, okay, I would turn the time over to Marc and Jennifer, and you can introduce yourselves.
Thank you, Mary. Thank you so much for your introduction. And thank you to the whole CS Music Online College Expo team for your incredible work planning and implementing this incredible expo, college fair, series of masterclasses. We are just thrilled to be here. I'm really excited to be sharing the next hour with my lifelong, longtime bestie, Jennifer Kay. And we're really excited to be interacting with you and hearing your music. We hope, of course, to Mia, if you're here, and or anybody that opts to sing today, to offer a tidbit or two for your consideration, of course, with our hope being just helping you feel even just a millimeter more excited about your repertoire and a little bit maybe more free in your singing. If we get to that, and of course, we're more than happy to entertain any questions that you might have. I would say pretty much anything is inbounds and allowed in terms of what you might want to ask. But that if you do decide to sing, yes, anything that you're like in process working on, something that you're on book still, maybe not fully memorized, or if you just have an excerpt from something that you might want our ears on and maybe just like a little input, we'd be happy to work on excerpts, even things that you're just getting going on, if you felt comfortable doing that. And then we would just say that if you do opt to sing, that please feel free to follow up with any questions that you might have about the things that we offer for your consideration, and of course always defer back to your teachers and maybe the team of people that helped prepare you to sing today, and to just make sure that the things that we suggest are well in line with things that you're working toward in your own singing life. So Dr. K, what am I forgetting to say at the outset here?
That was beautifully said, Marc, and that Marc and I love young singers, and we love hearing you at all stages, and so we just, we're happy to hear you sing today. So thank you for joining us.
Can you tell us a little bit about the program at Ithaca? Give us a little bit of an overview. I think that would be a great way to start. And Mia, if you have joined us while we've been waiting, I know you are one of the people we have signed up to sing. So would you just let us know if you are here? I know we've had a couple of people join, but not anybody named Mia that I've seen so far. So, and also, as I mentioned, we are looking for volunteers. So we'd love to have you volunteer. But in the meantime, Marc and Jennifer, tell us a little bit about the program.
We also very much appreciate that all of you being here tonight on this like Wednesday night session. We know things are kind of just getting going with the convention. And so it no big deal if what we end up doing is just question and answer. Jennifer is really great at talking about this special place that is Ithaca College. If you feel like you want to start us with that.
That mute button got me there, sorry. The Ithaca College School of Music is an unbelievably special community of we focus on undergraduate learning. We have a variety of majors, including music ed, performance, a combination degree of music education and performance, which is a 4.5-year program, bachelor's of music with an outside field, which is a really unique and special program that you get to kind of customize with your dual passion of what it is. It could be linguistics, business, theater, anything, you any other major at Ithaca College. We have sound recording technicians in our studios. We just have an incredibly diverse program, and the voice faculty, there are 11 of us at Ithaca College, and we teach all of those majors and all voice types, including the musical theater majors as well. So it's just a rich, vibrant community, and you know, if you have an opportunity to check out the website, and it's a beautiful place on top of that. So Marc, am I forgetting something?
Yeah, no, I think it's a really exciting time in the voice area in the School of Music that we, Jennifer and I and our esteemed, incredible colleagues have been hard at work just recrafting the curriculum, specifically in the performance degree for starters, to include just a really beautiful array of coursework that we think is aimed at helping, you know, young students in 2021 cultivate themselves and their music to sort of position themselves with skill sets, a knowledge base, performance experience, you know, for success and joy in sharing music out in the world as emerging young artists. And so we're excited that the incoming class, you know, next year will more than likely be sort of our pioneers on this maiden voyage of our new and improved performance degree, which will include a really rich combination of things in the acting and movement realm, for example, a whole sequence of classes aimed at helping singers establish greater skills in acting and movement. And by the way, these are our School of Music performance majors. As Jennifer mentioned, we also have a whole separate sort of curricula for our BFA music theater majors, but the School of Music students that are in the performance track will have acting and movement training. There will be a bolstered vocal pedagogy program, which will include a really beautiful sequence of classes that does involve opportunity for you to cultivate your skills as a teacher and hone your sort of expressive language and talking about singing with other singers. And then our diction sequence has been bolstered to just be a little more comprehensive and more an opportunity for students to take the musical material that they're working on in the studio setting and you know, really find themselves in sort of concept immersion mode using that repertoire in the diction classroom. And then also, you know, we have we've changed a little bit that what the experience for our students in the performance track will be regarding the collaborative aspects of being a singer. And so some work with our coaches and some more time built in to prepare degree required recitals. What else in the new curriculum that is not yet up and running, but in the very near future will be? Jennifer, what am I forgetting?
That was so beautifully said. That just a couple of things is that we have a collaborative piano major at Ithaca College, and so that we've been in the process of kind of pairing our performance majors and the collaborative pianist majors right off from the beginning, you know, hoping that we're making, you know, a love match and that we are fostering a beautiful piano vocal duo for 4 years, that you really get to grow as a collaborative pair and grow together. I think that's very unique. We have a beautiful, what we call voice intensive, where we take a week and we kind of trade you your voice lesson time and your studio lesson time for a week full of workshops on every possible conceivable topic that has to do with voice, everything from resume writing and web shops, you know, websites, and anything you can possibly think of. We're offering workshops, and we have outside presenters come in and help us with that as well. It's just a really rich community, and I wanted to echo and underline something that Marc had said earlier about the new performance program, kind of taking the work from the studio into the classrooms, and so that, you know, of course you're getting your beautiful and bespoke designer work with your studio teacher, but now you're getting access to all of these wonderful voice teachers, and so that we really have a rich, like, it takes a village to raise a really well-rounded and well-prepared singer in 2021. And so, and we've designed the curriculum so that the students are getting access to the full faculty.
And along those lines, in addition to the things that we've just mentioned, which are kind of in our sandbox, the voice performance realm, of course, there's a really beautiful combination of classes that you'll also take in your core coursework in the School of Music and out of the School of Music, and of course, including, you know, theory, history, sight singing, keyboard musicianship, and those kinds of things. And I love that you mentioned the voice intensive. Ours a couple of weeks ago had a performance practice session on singing spirituals with outside presenters that were amazing. A performance practice session on singing gospel music. A performance practice session on singing art song repertoire by Black composers. And then a really incredible, and all of those were outside panelists, and then a really incredible panel discussion with a professional conductor, two professional opera singers, a professional music theater singer, and a professional composer with our students, to just, that was sort of aimed at selecting appropriate repertoire. And anyway, that was just this season. And then we had Rhiannon Giddens and Francesco Turisi as well come and offer some really incredible things as a part of an outcropping of the voice intensive as well. Is Maria here? Is Maria, is this you?
It's,
are you singing?
It's Mia, actually.
Oh, Mia, I'm sorry.
That's okay. I just
Maria's like, am I singing?
Yeah. Well, Maria, if you want to sing, we'd love to have you sing, but I tell you what, we'll have you sing, but we will have you sing right after Luz. Luz, I think, just joined us, and she's going to sing. If you're still here. Mia, unfortunately, looks like she's not going to make it, so she won't make it. But Maria, if you have a song that you want to have ready, it's up to you. Don't feel pressured, but we'd love to have you if you want to. So, and you could go after Luz. If Luz, are you ready to sing?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Okay, perfect. If you want to introduce yourself and tell us what you're going to sing.
Yes, of course. My name is Luz Vizcarra. I am mezzo soprano. I am from Mexico City. I am graduated by the University of the Royal School of Music, and I am looking for a master, maybe away from Mexico, and I really want to work with my technique and to know more about vocality, about many kind of things. And I am totally grateful for this kind of opportunities during this difficult time for us, for staying at home, maybe with no more expectations about what will happen about our career. And I will sing Que Faro Senza Euridice by Gluck. Generally, I sing Bel Canto, but I discover new ways of repertory during this pandemic time. Oh, I'm sorry. During this pandemic time.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Luz. Thank you so much for the care that you took to present kind of so well-rounded a performance just now, that you led with heart and intention, that you delivered something that had its roots in the context of the piece, and that had its roots in heartfelt storytelling and real commitment to just staying in your picture. That's an impressive thing to do when you're, oh, I'm singing on a masterclass, to on the fly just get yourself into the headspace that is you know, just being an elevated artist in that way. Beautiful. I think you have just a stunning vocal instrument. It just so rich and colorful. I love the sound of your voice. And I think I have to also commend you for the ways in which you kind of move around throughout your range with great flexibility. Just classical resonance abounds. I think the thing that I would recommend at the outset, Luz, is just that you trust the natural warmth in your voice, that you're clearly a very comfortable mezzo, and that when you have closed vowels, that you just let them be just a little bit more clear and closed. That some of the E and A sounds, for example, to me sound just like a little bit overly darkened, or that you're coloring them with something that from my ear isn't the most Italian sound in E and A. That you're kind of singing eure dice, and you're singing che farò, and you're singing things like il mio ben. Even epsilon in Italian has just like a little bit of closed A sound in it. So I would invite you maybe just to spend a second and speak the opening lines of text for us, and just let E and A just have a little bit more front of mouth energy. Does that make sense to you?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Just say the words in rhythm. Go ahead.
Che farò senza Euridice?
Dove
andrò senza il mio ben? Che farò? Dove andrò? Che farò senza il mio ben?
Nicely done. And then just thinking, we close the vowels with our tongue. Say that. Say that for me.
Okay. Che?
Say closed. I close the vowel with my tongue. Just go ahead and say those words. I close the vowel with my tongue. That's just a mindset. Close vowel, loose jaw. Close vowel, neutral throat. There's space above and behind my closed vowel. These things, we're not looking to close your voice. We're just looking to close the closed vowels a little bit. Yes, keep going, just from where you stopped.
Che farò senza Euridice? Dove andrò senza il mio ben? Che farò? Dove andrò? Che farò senza il mio ben? Io son pure il tuo fedele. Io son pure il tuo fedele. Che farò?
Good. Just start from io son pure il tuo fedele, and see how much of that vowel closure and gorgeous vowel differentiation you can achieve with a loose jaw. A little bit what I'm seeing now, but you're so quick. I'm very impressed, Luce, that you're able to receive what I'm saying and give it a whirl. But a little bit now I'm seeing maybe a little more chewing than you were doing before. You've already achieved such gorgeous separation of tongue and jaw, and that's just healthy singing. And now you might be a little bit more actively involved in the jaw than you were before. So can you give us this differentiation and these beautifully closed sounds without so much jaw? So io son pure il tuo fedele. That kind of thing, that you're just loose here and active on the articulators and tongue. Go ahead.
Okay. Io son pure il tuo fedele. Io son pure. It's right?
Yeah. Yes. Beautiful. Could you sing the beginning this way with just a little bit more closure in E and A? Still a loose jaw. We're not chewing. We're not trying to close the vowel with the jaw. We're closing the vowel with the tongue.
Io son pure il tuo fedele. Io son pure il tuo fedele. Il tuo fedele.
Can I just hear fedele? With just a little bit more A sound in it. Nicely done. When E and A are allowed to step forward in clarity, is my point. My point, Luz, is that when E and A are allowed to step forward in clarity, a lot of the other vowels around them can also step forward, and you still sound like a beautiful mezzo. Like you don't have to warm mezzoize the E and A vowels in order to sound mezzo-y. Just a thought for your consideration. Sorry, Jennifer, please take it away.
No, as usual, we share a brain, and I would have gone after the same thing. I just want to, it's a gorgeous, gorgeous instrument, and you're so very musical. So it's a pleasure to hear you today. That I just want to keep empowering you and encouraging you that when a single vowel gets multiple pitches, that sometimes I feel like the second pitch on the same vowel, the vowel is different. And I just want you to just keep thinking about that consistency of vowel and rearticulating the beautiful verse vowel that you're setting up. And as a fellow mezzo, I just want to underline what Marc was saying, that when the clarity of the vowels is not the same as the beautiful richness of your voice. And so I don't want to lose the language in the gorgeous color that you have, that you can maintain that beautiful color and have clarity of language.
Thank you.
Where, I'm not looking at the score, but where is the place lose where we have multiple pitches over one syllable? I feel like it happens near the end, doesn't it? Ne dal mondo, ne dal cielo. Isn't that a place where there's like little, kind of little runs?
Avanza più soccorso, più speranza, né dal mondo, né dal cielo. It's right.
It's such a lovely instrument. So even if we just look at the word mondo, right, that we have, you know, that there's a tendency, especially when there's a nasal consonant that's next to the vowel, that for you to close to that nasal consonant, right, so that we get a little mondo, right, and then that also exaggerates I don't want to use the word overuse, but less efficient use of the jaw, right? That we really want to let this jaw be really efficient and let your smaller articulators do the work for you.
Okay.
Am I making sense to you, Luz?
Yes, totally. Thank you so much.
Yeah, I would love for you to sing that same little section again, if you don't mind. Really thinking about the, you know, the purity of vowel and maintaining that vowel to the very next pitch.
Okay. Anon m'avanza più soccorso, più speranza, né dal mondo, né it's different.
Beautiful. Would you sing this next line? Isn't this the next part? The next part that has ke fa ro. You have two pitches per syllable, just so that you can try Dr. K's idea there as well, where you rearticulate the vowel as you change pitch. And I just modulated us. I'm sorry. I'm not looking at a score.
Oh, no, don't worry. When I have this opportunity, I just take it. Che farò, dove andrò, che farò senza il mio me, senza il mio me, senza il mio me.
Luz, it's just, what a voice. So I want to keep encouraging you. So, and now I'm going to say something that's an enormous exaggeration from what you are doing. So please don't think you're actually doing this, but be very careful about K-E-F-A-R-O, right? Like, I feel like the second pitch almost gets almost a diphthong on it. And be really thoughtful, K-E-F-A-R-O, right? Like, really stay on that pure vowel sound. Your first vowel sound is lovely. and clear. And it's the second pitch that I think just needs a little bit more intentional thoughtfulness.
Okay.
And the top ones, as you kind of start yourself up this path of vowel repetition, as you change pitch, remember that the top ones really don't need so much rearticulation in the jaw. I was seeing you, if maybe you need to kind of open your mouth for that top space in order to give a little more acoustic space for that top note to fly, great. But don't chew to change pitch. Can you do the same place? You're so brave to try something new, and you're very quick on the uptake. Thank you for that. And I would just invite you to continue to kind of explore this idea and anticipate that one of the outcomes could just be even more gorgeous legato. Your legato is beautiful. Sometimes with an orchestra, I think that much rearticulation in the jaw would steal a little bit from the gorgeous line. But so when you're jawless and you're rearticulating your vowel, really we just hear one gorgeous sound bumping into another.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I will do it. Thank you.
That was beautiful, Luz. Thank you so much for joining us. Okay, well, I think we've had a couple of volunteers, so I don't know if you guys have gotten my notes. I think you have. So I think, Maria, if you are ready, you can unmute yourself. And then after Maria, then Marla will sing as well. And we have about half an hour, so about 10, 15 minutes for each of them. That'd be great. Thank you.
All right. Hi. Sorry, I just have to. So my name is Maria. I'm in grade 10. And so this is technically a junior senior class, but I wasn't planning on singing. So, and it just so happens I'm doing my grade 8 Royal Conservatory music exam in a couple of weeks. So I had some accompaniments and songs ready. You guys said I could perform either song that I am. So I'll do Romance in B major by Claude Debussy.
10th grade, no way.
I literally am blown away. I was like, how old does that make you? Are you 15?
Yes, 15. 16 in a couple months.
I'm blown away.
It's very, very sophisticated, musicianship and singing.
I'm just so impressed. I have to commend you. Are you studying French in school now?
Yeah, I know French.
I was going to say.
In French immersion.
Oh, I was going to say, what? What 15-year-old yeah. that sings beautiful French like that? So
yeah, I'm sorry.
Yeah, oh, it's quite lovely. So with your comfort level in French, I want to just empower you to really sing the words, right? You know, that I want you to like make every sound in a really with conviction. And that I find it to be so remarkable how beautiful and, you know, fluid your phrasing is. I mean, it's just absolutely lovely. But I want to give you like, I think that articulation can have just a little bit more energy to it. Do you mind starting from the beginning just with that idea?
All right, sure.
Yeah, and just let your whole body, the whole breath energy, send a little bit more conviction to the declamation of the text. You've got this.
All right. L'âme évaporée souffrante, l'âme douce, l'âme odorante. Sorry, I have to take my headphones out to sing and I can't hear you.
Oh, I'm so sorry. No, I'm just giving you the timeout. That was beautiful. What happens if we just doubled down on that idea and even went even further with it? Do you feel comfortable with that?
Sorry.
No, Maria, can you hear me? Oh, Maria. Can you hear us, honey?
Sorry about that.
You're fine. You're absolutely fine. We're so sorry to make you toggle between different technologies to do this. I mean, you're doing a beautiful job. I just want to encourage you to take that idea of energizing the text even further. I dare say you might feel like it's in bad taste how far I want you to go. I just want to challenge you and be like, go, just take it and let me say, okay, you went too far.
And Maria, you can just stay where you are with your earbuds in, and I'll give you your starting pitch now. You said you're in B. So here's your C sharp starting pitch. Yeah.
L'âme évaporée souffrante, l'âme douce, l'âme odorante des lits divins, que j'ai cru dans le jardin. De ta pensée.
Maria! Yes! Now, did that feel like it was in bad taste to you?
A little bit. I don't know. But
I have to tell you out here on our end, that's some fabulous singing. I just think it really needs to come that far. And that does not detract from the beautiful sentiment of this song or the style of Debussy. Like that we need that much energy in the text.
And that's coming from the queen of all things French melody. If Dr. K thinks that is exquisite French and beautiful kind of style and performance practice in Debussy, you just say, yep, okay, it is. Truly. I was so excited to hear, as you sort of linger in these sustainable consonants this way, I was excited to hear more of the tone spin naturally. And that can happen when we just decide that we're going to sing focused vowels, which yours are, because your French is idiomatic because you have these sounds in your ear, but that also that you let yourself in French lyric diction for singing, you let yourself linger in some of these sustainable consonants. I mean, we're exhaling when we say our words, right? And so I just feel like the word Dr. K used was just a little more energy in the approach. And there was more energy resulting in more steady breath flow, which resulted in just beautiful vibrato, which resulted in more legato. So it's a really nice domino.
Maria, I actually kind of adored what you did. I hope that didn't take you too far outside your comfort zone.
Yeah, it was fun. Yeah.
Well, I'm delighted. I mean, I think that you are so far along on this piece that simply by really energizing that text, I mean, and I love Marc's word linger on this, like on the consonants. Like, oh, I just think that French, I know this is going to sound silly, but sometimes to sing it, it feels good in your mouth. And I really want to let you enjoy saying these words and how wonderful they feel in your mouth.
Okay.
I am blown away by your musicianship and your voice. I was still singing to the radio. I didn't know what I was doing.
Marla, are you still willing to sing in a moment? We're so excited. Just let's give Maria like one more moment if we could. And we'll just, Maria, if you could sing, this is from the Meno Mosso. This is N'est-il plus un parfum qui reste? Is that okay, this next section? With these ideas in mind, just a little bit more energy on the articulators, a little bit more follow through with your sustainable consonants in French. And here's your D sharp.
N'est-il plus un parfum qui reste de la sauvette céleste? Déjà tout m'enveloppé d'une vapeur surnaturelle. Faite d'espoir, d'amour fidèle, de béatitude et de paix.
Those were consonants of longer duration. Those were not necessarily louder consonants, and that's excellent, right? That's so just like consonants of longer duration into which you're lingering, it really does add to the consonant legato. And trust your gut. There are so many of these phrases end in mutes, so like unstressed schwa, and you're letting yourself say céleste. You're sort of tapering into the final schwa, and you're surnaturel. You're tapering into the final schwa. Those mutes don't need an overt linger, and you're doing that. Fidèle, same idea. Two of the phrases end in stressed syllables, so you have enveloppé. You can let yourself linger into that syllable, and you can also say, what was the other one? Oh, d'espoir. You can give yourself a little accent insistance there, so trust yourself. Yay.
Right. thank you
for singing for us and volunteering, Maria. It's a joy to hear you.
Thanks. It was awesome being taught by I don't know, a judge or adjudicated by you guys.
You were so brave to like just jump in at the last second. So thank you so much for doing that. And you're beautiful, beautiful singer. Okay. Marla, are you ready?
Yeah. I'm really nervous to follow on behind after these two amazing singers. So and it's 6 a.m. in the morning here. So like my voice isn't warmed up yet. So I can't. I will just try my best. This is musical theater. It's pretty funny from Dogfight. So I will. It's just an excerpt from it because it's kind of long. So. Isn't it funny? Isn't it funny? Aren't you funny? Pathetically naive and desperate to believe you can always find some good. Well, you misunderstood. Are you I need a take two. I'm sorry, I'm really nervous. But that's the general idea. I don't know. Yeah.
Where are you that it's 6 a.m.?
Philippines.
Amazing.
I can't thank you enough for joining us at 6 o'clock in the morning. And how old are you, Marla?
I'm 50 and I'm in grade 9, so.
These amazing, the world of singing is in good shape with these amazing women in this class here today between Maria and Marla. Marla, I think you're doing a beautiful job. You have nothing to be, you know, we're just so happy you're here to join us. And I love this song.
I hope I'm not butchering it.
You are certainly not. I was just going to say that I just want to give you an opportunity. And at 6 o'clock in the morning, I'm not sure I would be able to do this. So I'm just going to put it out into the universe that I just want to give you an opportunity to continue to exhale through every, just keep exhaling, right? You know, that just keep making continuous sound, that, you know, musical theater is more legato than anyone ever gives it credit for being. So I just want you to sing the most legato phrase that that your body can manage at 6 o'clock in the morning.
Okay, so I'm gonna do that again. I will, yeah, okay, hold on. Oh shoot, wait. Isn't it funny? Isn't it funny? Aren't you funny? Pathetically naive and desperate to believe you can always find some good. Well, you misunderstood, or you've been dreaming. 'Cause people are just cruel. Yeah.
That totally worked. Always do that. This idea of really singing all the way to the end of the phrase and just mustering up like as much legato as you could had a beautiful impact, I think, on breath flow, and then also on resonance, didn't it, Jennifer? I wasn't expecting all of a sudden all those sustained E vowels to become non-nasal. So
it was a pleasant surprise. I wasn't expecting it either. But you see, she just needed a second go around. I think maybe this was more representative of her normal singing, right? Because I don't know if I'd want to get on a masterclass at 6 a.m. myself. So, but Marc, please continue. I'm sorry I interrupted you.
No, it's so great because I think part of what I was hearing, I mean, this whole excerpt is about the sustained E-vowel, right? It's funny, and that's a tricky thing to do because it's also the unstressed syllable. But I loved what just happened when, sorry, my keyboard yells at me if I don't. But it was really neat to see what just happened. Can you just sing the first couple of lines for us again? And when you have that sustained, I'm so boring. Oh my gosh. Jennifer talks about so elevated things. Anyway, I was just about to talk about a boring eval thing, which is just tap your corners a little bit while you sustain the eval. That a little bit right now, I'm just seeing kind of a little extra bite on it that I don't know that you need. Yeah, that in order to close our vowels, Luce and I were just working on this, that we don't have to go so far in that direction. We can just let them be closed inside of our mouths, right? We close the vowel with our tongue. We don't close the vowel with our jaw or with our corners. So can you just sing it again? And when you have a long note, keep doing the thing that you were just working on, which was the full connect to the end of the phrase from Dr. K, and also tap your corners just a little bit, just to notice that they can be basically in neutral.
So just the first two lines or the whole excerpt?
Before you sing it, will you just say the words in rhythm for us where you go, isn't it funny? No pitch necessary, just talking and just tapping your corners just to notice a little tactile feedback for you to notice the degree to which they're engaged.
Isn't it funny?
Your fingers moving, and can you say the words in with a little bit more head voice, like a little higher in pitch, so it feels like singing.
Sorry. Isn't it funny?
Great. Good. Dr. K, would you model what I mean with the speaking? Sorry, I don't think. Yeah.
No, it's fine. Higher. Happy to help. So a little bit heightened. So like, isn't it funny? I like that.
Okay.
Talk in this voice.
Okay. Isn't it funny? Isn't it funny?
Excellent. And I think if you were recording yourself, you would notice at playback that what you just did sounded beautifully like a closed vowel. You didn't actually need to go so far on the outside to close it. Amazing. Do the same thing and still speaking in your head voice place, still tapping so that we're neutral, and a little smile in the eyes. So at the moment, you're like all neutral because you're paying such close attention and doing exactly what we're asking. But it's possible to go too far neutral here. So can you find like a little smile in the eyes, but still neutral on the corners? So you're not smiling here. You're smiling here and still neutral here. Watch Dr. K do it. She's got the smize down. I was going to say this part, but I okay, go ahead, Marla.
Isn't it funny? Oh, wait, no. Isn't it funny? Isn't it funny?
Amazing. Sing it. Will you sing it that way and keep tapping and keep smizing?
Okay, I will. I'll get the minus. Is it? Wait. Isn't it funny? Isn't it funny? Aren't you funny? Yeah.
How does that vowel feel to you now, Marla?
It feels better. It feels much better.
I think it's wonderful. I think that you have this beautiful, natural smile that comes this way, and that it's very hard to counteract your natural joy in singing, right? And that was so beautiful and resulted in such a beautiful vowel and a warmer tone it was really quite lovely. Well done, Marc.
It just has, yeah, that gathered facial resonance. There's like a little breath energy coming almost behind the uvula and out through the cheekbones instead of just like straight out through the nose, which is really an easy trap to fall in when we're singing contemporary pop music theater, especially in that vowel. And I think what's interesting about this moment, and you'll have to correct me if I'm wrong, Marla, but is it really funny? Like this moment, is she talking about like, isn't it funny that something kind of sad is happening right now? Am I right about that? I don't know my dog fight context. Yeah. So it's not really funny. So she wouldn't be necessarily genuine ear to ear grin. Right.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. I don't know what else to say.
Thank you.
I'm so happy really that you joined us. Thank you.
That was beautiful, Marla, and thank you so much for jumping in last second. Again, very brave, both you and Maria, for doing it, and Luz as well. She came in very last minute, so all of you are amazing. Okay, well, we just have a few more minutes, so if you guys have any questions, we would love to have you ask any questions from Jennifer, Marc, whether musical theater or classical or about their program. Or about them personally. Just joking. We'd love to have you ask any questions. You are welcome to either raise your hand digitally or actually, or you're also welcome to put anything in the chat. So let's see if we have any questions. We don't have anybody jumping quite right now. So about how many students do you have in your program? And then Maria has a question after that.
I just missed the first like 10 minutes, so I was wondering.
Okay. She missed the when they were introducing their program. You missed that? Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I was just wondering. It's not for everyone, so answer the other questions first. But.
Okay. Well, if you want to tell us about how many people you have in your program, and then Maria, you'd be welcome to ask your specific question. That'd be fine.
Well, Marc, if I get these numbers wrong, but with School of Music, including the BFA theater majors and the School of Music, there's about 200 singers at Ithaca College. It's a very large program, particularly for the relatively small size of our college, which is around 5,500 total students. So it's a big program, 11 faculty members at Ithaca, voice faculty members at Ithaca College, and about 70 School of Music faculty members in total. It's a vibrant program with lots of different majors, everything music education, performance and music education, bachelors of music with an outside field, sound recording technology, the bachelors of fine arts in musical theater. I'm sure I'm forgetting majors. it's a very vibrant program.
Oh, that's amazing. That's wonderful. A very musical school, it sounds like. So that's wonderful. Okay, Maria, would you go ahead and ask your question?
Sorry, my question was actually just about the college. I was just worried that you guys had already answered and talked about it a lot before I got on.
We didn't really. I mean, Ithaca College.
General, I don't know.
Ithaca College, the School of Music is one of several professional schools, but it is very much students that come kind of enjoy an opportunity to have kind of a liberal arts experience in addition to their music coursework that students are able to really take advantage of coursework from all different kind of areas of study. Yeah. And so ask specifically, was that just basically what you meant? Like other things you can... Just open-endedly, that's okay.
Yeah, sorry.
No, that's okay. Yeah, and you know, one of the things Jennifer said as we started was that we have this degree that's called a Bachelor of Music with an outside field, which lots of students really love because you can study music and you get your hour lesson, your 60-minute lesson weekly, and you take voice, you know, all for the entire 4-year trajectory, but then also you end up with, you know, pretty significant coursework in an outside field of your choosing. And it's definitely a bump up from a minor, you know, like some students would do like a major in music and then a minor in something else. But the BMO is definitely a more bolstered outside field experience. We have some, I think one of the examples that Jennifer shared was like, we have students that would do like a Bachelor of Music with an outside field in business or outside field in theater studies or, you know, speech and language pathology. We have an amazing communication school. And all kinds of different opportunities for you to like continue to grow your musical passion and abilities, and also at the same time, get some really great college experience in other areas.
And just to round it up, that the college in general is a residential college that's primarily focused on undergraduates. We do have a small graduate school graduate program in the School of Music, but it is a primary undergraduate institution, residential in lovely Ithaca, New York. If you ever just want to do Google Maps, it's quite beautiful here. Although it did snow here all day, and I probably shouldn't tell you that here on April 21st that it snowed all day, but it did.
I got snow here in Canada too. So.
Oh, okay. Well, then you're ready.
And it snowed here in Utah on Sunday. So, you know, So Maria, let me ask you a question. Are you wanting to go into voice studies? Do you have a specific area of study you want?
I'm not sure. I was, my teacher just emailed me about this college expo like a week ago, and I thought it sounded really interesting. So I was just going to listen on a few sessions. And I've been thinking of going to university for music. I really enjoy singing and I want to keep doing it. I'm not entirely sure about a career in music, so I don't know. I also like sciences, so I've been looking at like joint bachelor's with music and science. I live in Ottawa and there's one at University of Ottawa, but I've been looking around as well.
Oh, that's amazing. That's wonderful. Go ahead, Jennifer.
I was just going to say that as Marc was pointing out with the Bachelor of Music with an outside field, one of my current students is doing that and her outside field is neuroscience. So, I mean, we have, you know, that I just wanted to, you know, point that out, that we have everything. I mean, that outside field is open and she's really interested in moving on into music cognition is where she thinks that her path is. So it's just, we get some really wonderful, interesting, diverse students, and that's what makes it a wonderful community.
That is amazing. Okay, well, I think we are basically out of time. I just wanted to mention for Maria or anybody else, Marla or whoever is listening, just a reminder that we're having the College Expo. Let's see, I just want to make sure I tell you the right times that we'll be doing that on Friday from 4 to 8. And Saturday noon to 8. So you can kind of go into the breakout and recruiting sessions and visit with the different colleges. Jennifer and Marc, do you know the time that Ithaca will be there?
Marc's gonna find it.
I'm sorry I put you on the spot. I could probably look it up as well, but it would probably take me longer too. I just thought we would go ahead and mention it so that if anybody is interested, they can go and hear more and ask you any other specific questions that they might come up with between now and then. So you can definitely find it on the schedule if you just go to our website and just look for Ithaca, and you'll be able to ask any other additional questions. So does that help?
At that session, our admissions director, Bradley Whittemore, will be there, and he is the king of all answers to all questions. So, you know, things that, you know, Marc and I, out of our faculty perspective, might not know about, you know, financial aid and other things like that, that he's the man to ask all those questions to.
It is, and I found that I don't know if it's a full 2-hour window, Mary. Maybe you can help us figure that out, but I have set up Saturday the 24th from 2 to 4. Does that sound right?
Yeah, that sounds right. Uh-huh. Yes. So, yeah. Okay, that's perfect. So, yeah, Maria, if you have more questions, you can join Bradley then on Saturday from 2 to 4. So, thank you, Jennifer and Marc, so much for being here today. And thank you to all of our singers. It was a really great class. And you guys have a great day, and hopefully we'll see you again.
Thank you, Maria and Marla and Abigail and Maria joining us.
Thank you.
Bye.
Best to you.